This is a 10 out of 10 tutorial in which we follow the line and we stop at the first intersection. Why? Because in this way we build consistent, reliable robots that do not depend on rotations and on timer, then depend only on sensors and in this time the intersection. How consistent and reliable could the robot be with this program? We start, we move, we reach the intersection, we stop. That's it. And now we can start from a different place. We don't have to start from the same place because we don't depend on rotations and we don't depend on timer. We just depend on the event that on the right side of the robot there will be a line. And even if the wheels slip or the battery is low or something pushes the robot on the side or any other thing happens, doesn't matter. We are not in any way dependent on this. We are not in any way affected by this. We just move forward until we see another line on the right. And as you can see, the robot is quite consistent and it also is very reliable. It arrives at the same place every time. And we'll extend this program in some of the next tutorials. We'll also, after we reach this intersection, we'll align on this intersection. We'll align to the line, which is also improving the accuracy of where we are on the field. For now, first step, just move forward and stop at the first intersection. One more try. As we've discussed in other tutorials, this algorithm for line following, it could be configured. So you can configure how sharp the turns are. And you can do this by configuring the movement block that we use in the program. And in this way, you can configure the robot to follow the line in a way that's kind of smooth or in a way that has more sharp turns. And this depends on what you want to get from the robot. What you should do, check the previous tutorial, check the program, check the explanation, download, experiment, and make sure you understand how you can stop on an intersection, because it's one of the most important concepts. See you in the next tutorial.